stats are coming up. Any head injuries or recent falls?
No head injuries in his chart or recent falls.
Ready?
Let's begin.
In med school, we do something called the practice of medicine, which is a course where we learn how to take a history and do a physical and essentially learn how to be a doctor. And as I went through the physical exam, I thought to myself, do I know how to take care of my friends and my family?
How do his lungs sound?
Still coarse, but I'm hearing air on both sides.
I had a friend named Helen who had cerebral palsy. And when I thought about taking care of her, I really didn't know how best to do an exam with her in a wheelchair. I didn't know how to do things up to the standard of care that she deserved. You know, discussing, you know, pressure sores is sometimes an uncomfortable situation, or it might require somebody to take extra effort to turn her over. Talking about sexuality with a patient with disabilities is often something people don't ask about because they don't know what the answer is going to be. And so when I approached some of the faculty members and asked, so when do we learn the modified exam of how to take care of somebody with a disability, I realized that was actually missing in the curriculum. And when I did more investigation, it wasn't just missing from WashU, it was missing nationally. We brought some patients in and we had some attendings and we had a discussion with patients about what it's like to live with whatever disability they had and really focusing on quality of life and patient care. And I'm very proud to say that this has now grown to be a 4-year part of the curriculum, integrated into practice of medicine. And as I worked on this project, I realized how passionate I was about improving healthcare and healthcare delivery. The focus of the disability curriculum wasn't just to learn the nuts and bolts of an exam and what to do, but it was really to understand how to approach a patient and to treat everybody with the dignity and the respect that they deserve.